I'm gonna be honest with you guys. I've tried this at least a dozen times now, so it better work this time. Just saying. I got a clean red deck of cards here. Nothing fancy about this deck. I'm gonna take the Eight of Diamonds, already nice and signed for you guys. Place it right here. All right. So far, so good. Why is this not? This is why I haven't been doing magic tricks on this channel. It's stressful. So, I'm gonna take this Sharpie, draw a little star on here for you. Now, watch what I can do with this star. Come closer, watch. There comes a point in every mountain biker's career where they mess up. It could be a broken collarbone, a dislocated finger, it could be a broken kneecap, messed up legs. For me, I got lucky with the amount of damage that I did to my bike. I probably should have gotten way more hurt than I did, but I did manage to walk away with a banged up knee and a lot of scrapes on my leg and on my other leg and on my stomach and just everywhere. I just got really banged up, but I am okay. I did not break anything that I know of. But there is one thing that would have saved me all of that pain. It would not have stopped the accident. It wouldn't have stopped me from breaking my bike, but it would have saved me a lot of pain, and it would have made it so that I could walk correctly for the next week until it heals. That is knee pads. I wear these religiously. Like, I wear these every single time I am on my bike. Not even just on the trails, just biking around, goofing around. I wear these. And I wear elbow pads too. This was the only time that I did not wear either of these. The only time. It was late. We decided to do a little bit of night riding on the trails over at Corey's. It was a last minute decision. I was like, okay, we're just gonna go out for about 5 or 10 minutes and then be done. I don't need these. I'll be fine. It's worse because I even had these with me. I just decided not to put them on. And yeah, that's how it happens. That was my first mistake, was not putting these on. And that's just what affected me physically. The second part, before I go into exactly what's wrong with my bike, I want to explain to you guys a little bit of what happened. So it got dark and we had just finished connecting a new trail to the system, but it wasn't really all that rideable yet. So we decided to call it a night and do a couple runs before leaving, and it got dark out. So I got my new floodlights on because I really wanted to try them out. And by the way, they work really well. Maybe I'll do a review on them in the future. But anyways, went up to this jump right here. And yeah, that's pretty self-explanatory as to how I messed up. I didn't hit it with enough speed. And with how the landing area is currently built, my back tire slammed against the corner, the front edge of that landing area. And basically, me along with the bike just stopped. Literally just stopped. I slammed my knee against my bike, then I fell off, and I didn't like slide or anything. I literally just fell straight to the side, and it hurt. It hurt a lot. I spent the next 10, 15 minutes debating on whether I was gonna need to go to urgent care or not. So, luckily, I am okay. I might have a little bit of a limp for a little while, but to be honest, I'm more mad at myself because I just bought that bike. That is a new bike still, and I messed it up. Luckily, I only broke one part of the bike, but I still broke part of the bike. And it is a part of the bike where it's pretty difficult. Like, normally, I crack my rim. Normally, if you crack your rim doing something, usually you're gonna get more hurt than that. To put that much force in your bike, you're gonna be hurt. And again, luckily, I did not get that hurt. My leg is all scraped up, as you can see. Also, I have a few bruises on my other leg and my stomach, and it doesn't feel that good. But yeah, this mistake runs me a little over $200 and at least a week's worth of riding, which really sucks because they just did a lot more work over at the Brunswick Trail that I just checked out today. I just hiked around a little bit, and checked it out, and it made me really excited to get back on the trail, but it also made me really jealous of all the people who are still riding and who got to test all those trails out today. So this mistake cost me about $200. This falls under misuse of your bike, and Trek does not cover that, which makes me kind of wonder, like, what do they cover? Because it sounds like the only things they really cover, especially like even with the frame, is just if it comes broken, which it shouldn't really be coming broken anyways. So I'm not really sure what the point of the warranty is. But anyways, that's a conversation for a future day. I'm not bashing Trek at all. I mean, I'm the one that broke the bike, so of course I'm gonna pay for it. It does worry me that I spent that much money on a bike and it broke fairly easily. I mean, my tires were pumped up to about 30 PSI and I fell from about 3.5 feet, 4 feet. And I feel like that shouldn't really break a rim, but anyways, that's what happened. I made a mistake. I paid the price physically and out of my wallet. So yeah, that is what happened with me. And yeah, honestly, all I gotta say is even if you spend a lot of money on a bike, you still gotta be careful with it. Don't treat it like trash. Also, if you're getting into mountain biking, get some knee pads. I see 99% of people that I see out on the trails these days are not wearing these, and those people are going to regret it. I regret not wearing them one time. All it takes is one time. You could ride 100 times with these and not fall and be like, I don't need these. And then you take it off one ride and that's when you fall and that's when you get hurt. So be safe. Get these. I will link these down in the description if you want to check them out. I actually really love these. They're very comfortable and they do the job and they're not that expensive. I got these from REI, but you can have them shipped to you. I don't know if they're still doing free shipping with all the stuff going on right now, but yeah, definitely worth looking into. Hopefully I will get back on the trail as soon as possible and I'll get some more videos for you guys, because like I said before, that was a lot of fun, especially at Schaefer. That was a lot of fun to just leave the GoPro in my head, let it record, let it do its thing. Then I go out and enjoy myself. I hang out with my friends, I just ride, and then at the end of the day, I look back over the footage and I just edit it together, and it was fun. It was amazing. I really like doing that. So I want to do that a lot more. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you want to watch more mountain biking videos from me, stay tuned. If you want to see some hiking videos, also stay tuned for those, because they will be coming up shortly. I do have a few things that I want to discuss about my hike next year and some of the gear changes I'm going to be doing. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Thank you guys, and I will see you guys next time. Peace. Alright, so if you guys actually made it this far in the video, I have a quick little present for you. Alright, so obviously you can't pick a card through the screen physically. I'm gonna make you pick a card a little bit of a different way. Alright, so I want you to ignore this bottom card here. Let me get this to focus on my hand. I'm just gonna riff it on the deck like this, and I want you to pick out a card that you see and memorize it. Alright, ready? I'll do this twice for you. Watch. I'll get a little closer. Got it? All right, so I know you guys think that I could cheat by just looking through the lens here and seeing what you guys saw, but the thing is, how would I know where that card is? So I'm not gonna cut this. I'm just gonna go ahead and fling the card out like this and then show it to you. But first, if I get this right, you gotta hit that like button right over here. If I get it wrong, comment down below what card you saw. And be honest, I'll know if you're lying. I'll know. You guys ready?